Greetings and Shalom Aleichem, friends. Thank you so much, Rav Yaakov Klein, for all of your amazing work with the Lost Princess Initiative, and thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to share a little bit of Torah with all of our friends. Today's Torah is from the Ishbitzer Rebbe, the Me'ah Shiloach, who shares with us a beautiful insight in how to treat and how to understand ourselves. Very often we're quick to give ourselves negative labels. We like to label ourselves. I have a bad temper, I have no self-control, I'm a failure, I'm a lo yitzlach, I'm not successful, I'm mediocre. All these negative labels. And when we do that, we set limits on who we can be. We don't look at ourselves within our full potential, our full ability to be the great people that we are. And the Ishbitzer teaches us that actually if we learn how to look at ourselves from a different angle, a different perspective, we actually see that a lot of those things that we feel are holding us back, there's actually a hint of beauty in them, there's actually a kedusha in them, and we can just turn things around and use them for the good and use them for the positive. And he bases this idea on a Gemara in Shabbos, a very famous Gemara, that's speaking about the Luchos. We know the Torah says that the words of the Luchos, the words of the Aseres Hadibros, were carved into the Luchos. And the Gemara goes so far to say that they weren't just carved, but they went straight through front to back. So Rav Chisda says that actually all of the words, if you read it from looking at it, you could read it the correct way, but if you were looking at it in reverse, everything would actually be kind of the mirror image, right? As one could envision, one could imagine. And then the next words of Rav Chisda are very unusual, because Rav Chisda gives examples of a couple of different words, and he shares how if you look at those words from one side, it would read one way, and if you look at it from the other side, it would read another way. An example is the word nivuv, nun beis vav beis, where if you read it from the back, it would be beis vav beis nun, and he gives a couple of examples, but what's unusual about these examples, and Tosus asks this question, is that these are not words that are part of the Aseres Hadibros, they're not part of the Ten Commandments. So of all of the words that Rav Chisda could have used, why does he specifically choose words that are not even there, that are not even present on the Luchos? And comes along the Ishbitzer Rebbe and says something beautiful. And this is the quote. V'hush Rav Chisda Amar, that Rav Chisda is saying, Rav Chisda is really teaching us, ki yesh koach b'divrei Torah, that there is a power in the words of Torah, l'shanos esleva adam mehepech lehepech, to transform a person from one extreme to another extreme, to take certain aspects of our personality that we think, this is not such a good aspect, this is not such a good part of us, and transform them into something that is holy. Because what are the examples that Rav Chisda gives? Well, one example is he says the word nivuv. Nivuv means a person that's empty. I'm empty, there's not a lot to me. I'm shallow, I'm superficial. Well, you change it around the other way, it's beis vav beis nun that has the root of bina, intuition, knowledge, depth. Another word, Rav Chisda says, if you read it on one side, it's rahav, but the other way, it's beis heiresh bahar. Well, rahav is arrogance, he says. But if you look at it the other way, beis heiresh on the mountain, I can transcend, I can be higher, I can be greater. The next word is soru, which he says is also a language of getting angry. But if you read it the other way, it's vav resh samach, which he says means something that is rach, something that is soft and something that is sweet, edel. So every single word, when it's read the other way, actually shows and it implies something that is great, something that is good. What a wonderful idea. And this is true. This is true with how we look at ourselves as well. We have to take a look at all of those aspects of ourselves that maybe we think are bad and say, but Hashem gave this to me. Hashem made this a part of me. So obviously there is a way to look at this as being good. And if I immerse myself enough in holiness and kedusha, I know I'll be able to turn it around. Many of us have had the experience of being in one of these holy places or a holy moment or in the presence of a tzaddik, of a great person. And at that moment, we looked at the world and we looked at ourselves in a whole new way, a moment of actually feeling what it's like to transcend any yetzer hara, any negativity. That beautiful feeling, and that can be us all the time. As long as we learn the words of Torah, the words of Pnimius HaTorah, and as we learn the Torah, we're looking to really integrated into us, not just a study, but something that we really care about, something that we're really trying to integrate into our essence. You know, we know the famous Mishnah in Pirkei Avos says that the language of engraved, the words were engraved on the luchos, charus al luchos, should really be read cheirus, which means freedom. When we start looking at ourselves with that ahava, with love, realizing that every single part of ourselves, both the good and the bad, has in it that kedusha, then suddenly we have cheirus, we have freedom, we feel free from the shackles of our yetzahara. We know that even though there's minor setbacks, but we have the ability to grow, we have the ability to transcend, we have the ability to be greater. The Ishbitzer is teaching us how to look at ourselves with love. And now we need to go out, and we need to do that. We need to learn Torah and integrate the words and really learn how to discover that true beauty and kedusha and holiness that is buried deep inside of us.